the power, and I walked over to her. I said, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you go out, you know? And nothing happened. And then I said, God, give me revelation. And God showed me a brickyard where they made bricks. And I saw this little girl at the age of 5. She was 20 then. I saw her at the age of 5. I said, you're 5 years old. She started screaming, no. I said, you are. And you're playing at the brickyard where they make bricks, you know, like Coro brick and stuff. And I said, and you're picking up a big mask that come from a big Zulu woman. And this Zulu woman stood there and was cursing your house. And because you do not believe in Jesus, your family didn't believe in Jesus, you got the curse and the demon is in you. And I say, I see the demon jumping between you and your cousin. And then they told me they had a little cousin that every time this girl is sane, the cousin would get insane. When the cousin would get sane, the girl would get insane and the demon would jump between the two of them. But the minute I saw where it came from, the thing had to leave because it was revealed. And I said, I know who you are. I know where you come from. And she screamed, wah! She fell to the ground, soggy wet. And as I looked at her, God said, this thing is coming back tonight. And the only thing that will protect her is she must be filled with the Holy Spirit. And I looked over to her and said, I can't explain. And she was tired, you know, hours sweating, cursing demons and stuff. I said, be filled with the Holy Ghost. Speak in other tongues. I couldn't explain. I couldn't tell her. She opened her mouth and, oh, maleo bre, leneno bustanale avre, di quebrasto, shoto, lobabros, adida varakira maha. Speaking in tongues is actually the Holy Spirit taking control of your tongue, and you make yourself available for the Holy Spirit to pray through you mysteries that you don't even know. What do we do with one of the greatest gifts on earth? It's not the smallest. I believe tongues should be the greatest gift that we can have on earth. Because if tongues is praying mysteries to God, if tongues is that the devil can't understand what you're praying, because verse 2 of 1 Corinthians 14 says, no one understand what he prays, because by the Spirit he prays mysteries unto God. In other words, your father will not know what you're praying, your mother will not know, your wife will not know, your husband will not know, the devil will not know. The Bible says, no one understands, but by the Spirit you speak mysteries unto God. If that is so awesome and so big, why don't we make use of the Holy Spirit that's actually on the inside of us? Say, if you will allow me, I'll pray through you to the Almighty God, and I'll help you pray mysteries. I'll pray for stuff that you don't even know what to pray for. I'll pray for stuff that you don't even know how to pray for it. What do we do with it? Okay, I told you the story previously of Maxwell White that wrote the book The Power of the Blood, you know, that said when God said to him, tongues is a sign for unbelievers. You know, it says it twice. It says it's for believers, then it says it's for unbelievers. He said, because if an unbeliever comes and you speak in tongues, he will say you're mad. But the next verse says, if an unbeliever comes, you know, he will fall on his face and acknowledge that God is with you, you know, and stuff like that. And he says he took that scripture and he went to the mall and he stood on the corner there. So he stood there. Good morning. Can I tell you about Jesus? Oh, I got my church. Good morning. Can I give you this tract? No, I have my church. You know, people come and he testified. I said, excuse me, lady, can I talk to you about Jesus? No, I've got my church. Excuse me, sir, can I talk to you about Jesus? No. He said, the next guy came out and said, sir, excuse me. Ma brazo brevedeke shake. He said, the guy started shaking and said, would you lead me to Christ? You know? And I thought, you know, but we will not do that. We will not do that, you know? So I can tell you over and over how powerful it is. I gave a series of speaking in tongues here on a Monday, Tuesday, and a Wednesday. And the same night in the church across the road, they had meetings about why tongues are not for today. While I was teaching on tongues, they were teaching the opposite. So the one guy that was in our church, we were going together, you know, to the spa here across the road. So we were standing there, and he was mumbling, speaking in tongues. So he looked miserable, you know. And so the guy at the till said, yo, everybody could see you had a miserable day. He said, no, I'm speaking in tongues, you know. The guy said, tongues? In our church, they told us last night that's not real. So this guy said, you know, he said, no, it's real. Listen, the guy said, no, anybody can do that. He said, the Dumni told us last night, anybody can make those noises that they do there by Lovdal. You know, anybody can do it. And this guy, it was so awesome. He said, so do it. The guy said, what? He said, speak in tongues. Your reverend told you last night, anybody can mumble that stuff that they do there by that church. He said, would you do it? The guy said, do what? He said, speak in tongues. He said, no, I can't. He said, well, why do you believe them? He said, I can. Zekra, Marco, Boro, Shekit, Leveste, Mambra, Zuzalava, Jekre, de Meraviri, Sobra. I can. The guy looked at him and said, can I come to your church tonight? Huh? So, I mean, but we, what will we do with the greatest gift that God has given us apart from salvation and eternal life? How much emphasis do we put on speaking in other tongues? You see, they took one scripture, or tongues will cease. They took another scripture, you know, if nobody has an interpretation, let everybody keep quiet. But what about he that speaks in an unknown tongue, edify himself, build himself up? Oh, you know, I feel so down today. Have you tried speaking in other tongues, sucker? You know? Yeah, but you know, I'm going through a tough time. Well, try tongues. You know, try making a river flow from the inside and it'll wash all that dirt away, you know. Why don't you lift yourself up? I remember we went to a movie house shortly after I got saved. No, I got saved speaking in other tongues. Okay. I went to this one church in Kempton Park, you know, loaded. So this is not fair. He said, 15 years I'm trying to speak in tongues. I remember the other guy, his name was Glenn, you know, and he had this long, we were all like hippies, he had this long beard and he always sat like cross legs playing his guitar. And Glenn said, no, they've been praying for me for 3 years. And I'm Rehabra Solomo Brajivelavakeshake. The next morning, I got to work. The first guy I met took out his cigarettes. Hey, Chris, scave, bro. I said, no. Hey, the sky is blue. The grass is green. Hey, save my mate, Joe. I was that man, you know. I was, no more this, no more that. Now I was, wow, speaking in other tongues. I didn't know. So thinking, you must watch out for that tongues. You know, that could be the devil. You know, I mean, you didn't pray the sinner's prayer. I mean, you know, you didn't go through the 5 steps of salvation. You know, you didn't go through a course in this and a course in that. I prayed in tongues. I didn't backslide. I didn't go back to this. I didn't go back to smoking, drinking, potting. I didn't do anything. I got started preaching. The next Friday, I preach on the street corner with a guitar around my neck. I'm still preaching. Okay? So what do we do with the greatest gift that God has given us? Okay? I find myself, I fall asleep. Rando Boda Mara Kiriri. And I thought, maybe that's why I don't sleep. I'm so alert that he that prays in an unknown tongue edifies himself. But I do find myself falling asleep praying in tongues. And I realize I've fallen asleep. But then it's an hour later and I'm not tired. I'm more awake when I fell asleep. And you know, and I find myself waking up speaking in other tongues because that's how I fell asleep. No, I didn't fall asleep saying, ooh, tomorrow. No, my notebook does that for me. My notebook thinks, what must you do 10 o'clock? What must you do? That's why you have a notebook, okay? You don't think what you do tomorrow. Your notebook thinks better than you. You think, if I do fall asleep speaking in tongues, thank you for watching. If I forget to say good night, Jesus. You see, but our legalism, oh, if we didn't pray an hour before we go to bed, didn't pray an hour in the morning, why not? Why if you're very, very tired, say, good night, Jesus. And you dream how you're healing the sick. You dream how you're preaching on street corners. And you wake up like this. Go to work. He that prays in an unknown tongue edify himself. Okay? How is it then, brothers? I will pray with my spirit, but I will also pray with my understanding. We just change it around. We will pray with the understanding. And maybe if we feel better after half an hour, we switch to the spirit. So we start off by telling God all the evil we are. Father, because we're going to pray to God, imagine if I've got sin in my life, God's not going to hear me. So prayer life starts like this. Heavenly Father. Oh, Father, forgive me that I did this morning. Forgive me that I did this. So we must first make right because otherwise we're not going to get through because we're going to be in a war between us and God, you know? So we first confess everything. Father, we thank you. Father, forgive us. Father, forgive us. Oh, Father, forgive us. Father, forgive. By the time you've forgiven everything, it's realized it's time to go somewhere, you know? So why don't you do what the Bible says? How is it, brothers? I will pray with the Spirit, and I will pray with the understanding. So I don't start with, Heavenly Father, this morning, and then God's not going to hear you. You committed sin. So I quickly go to the repentance. Father, forgive me. So I go to the little black curtain. I said, Father, I've got repentance. Father, forgive us, forgive us, forgive us, forgive us, forgive us. Good, my daughter, you can pray now. Father, I thank you for giving me that new dress. Father, thank you for the money for the car. Thank you, Father. And by the time I'm finished, I don't feel better. I actually feel worse. I don't feel I've spoken to God. Maybe he didn't hear me because, you know, I didn't know if I maybe confessed everything. Maybe I confessed half the stuff. What about falling on my knees and saying, Nakatiste barave, shibreveto sulama, Father, my Father, my Father, rende balaka shekere, oh, my Father, rahaba, sobro di shenera bandidira, my Father, roko broshete lemena. Father, I thank you today. I thank you, Lord, for the way you did that. Father, thank you for that. Thank you for that. Rako bo brashida. I forgot to ask. Oh, but my Father knows what I need before I ask. So, Father, please just remember, I need today 200 rand. I need to get that. I need that. I need that. I need that. Okay? What about walking in the Spirit? And not only doing it when I get to my prayer room and my inner room and my secret place, okay? What about Galatians 5:16? He that walk in the Spirit will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Taking the walk right to the Bible word walk, which is halak, which means to talk. Okay? No, it's not walking in the Spirit. It's actually talking in the Spirit. So it's not he that... How do you walk in the Spirit? How do you walk in the Spirit? And I got it, you know that, out of, you know, Genesis 5, where Enoch walked with God. And when God said to me, that walking is actually talking. Because how do you walk with God? I come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses. And he walked with me and he talked with me, tells me I am his own. You are my own son. Oh, thank you, Father. How do I walk with God? You know? And I had the Charles Finney's Dakes Bible then. And I looked, so I quickly go to the wall. And he said, the Hebrew word for walk is actually talk. It means to be in conversation with one person. Not to 10, but to one person. In other words, you switch all other conversation off and you talk to one person. So Enoch talked to God. And God said, Enoch, come here, man. These people will not understand you anymore, so just come. And he just, right into the cloud. So what about we walk? You're not going to walk to the cloud, but, you know, we've got a different dispensation now. We joined with the cloud. Yeah? So what about I do it? I do it. I do it. I do it. I do it. If you hear me pass you, you'll hear me. Sometimes I just turn the channel a bit softer, you know. What about when you finish? You're on your way to your classroom now. You're on your way to the working place. Either you can talk about, you know what that guy said to me? Did you see how she acted this morning? Did you see that? You know, what about, you know, say, I can sneak to my class and converse with God without anybody interrupting me. I can go to my secret place without going to a place. I can lock myself up in my secret room without locking myself up. I can just turn around here and know she's now going to follow me. He's now going to follow me. I know she's going to now moan about that. And he's going to talk about that. And, you know, so I just, secret place, rehear, share clever. Right? Okay, see you later. And I walk. You don't have to shout it that everybody hear how spiritual you are. You know, just talk in the spirit. And before you know it, you're always on a constant high. You never hit a low because you decided to take God at His word. You decided to take what we think the smallest, which is actually the greatest, gift of God, and we practice it, exercise. Who knows? Maybe we will be edified. Who knows? Maybe the Spirit will pray mysteries. Who knows? Maybe I will see things in the Spirit. Maybe God will reveal revelation. Who knows? Maybe I'll get victory over some agitative and addictive, you know, habits that I have. Maybe the depression, maybe the screaming, maybe the cursing. Maybe, you know. How can you pray in the Spirit and curse, you know? Kebra basha, who lightning thunder raka shekalama, you know, lightning thunder shekarabale doko shenema. Walk in the Spirit, you shall not fulfill Go sit in the pub and drink while you speak. They'll throw you out. They will not wait for the Spirit to lead you out. They will chuck you out, you know. You go sit there and say, so, maraka shebraba. Shekeba rangaba sheke. Nebraba sekarada. Rabba. You will not drink it. They will help you not to drink it. You will not be able to spend an hour there. They'll help you not to spend the hour there. Imagine somebody comes to you and say, hey, shall we go and crack a joint? And you say, Ramama Sheke. Hey, stay away. They will help you not doing it. They will help you not doing it. Okay. What do we do with the greatest gift God has given us? I just thought maybe we should just get, you know, pray more in the Holy Spirit. You know, pray more. I mean, I was shocked at the pastor's conference when I talked about, you know, how many does not pray in the Holy Spirit? About 300 people. I thought there's going to be five, you know, preachers. People come and say, I've got this ministry. I'm in the ministry now 15 years. But in my ministry, I don't see power. Do you speak in tongues? Tongues. Yeah, I didn't want to heal the sick, but you don't pray in tongues. Oh, must I pray in tongues? I'm serious. They're in the ministry. They don't know they can speak in tongues. You know, I said, my goodness, that's the first thing you must be able to do. Before you want to heal the sick, start praying in the Holy Ghost. Start speaking in other. Before you try, please pray for me. I'm so depressed today. Why don't you just go to yourself and say, Re Keba. Look in the mirror and say, Kuzi, look, sonny boy. Rambra Sheke, Naka Sheka, Robro Subraba. Anoint yourself with spit if you got no oil with you. Jesus did it and the blind man saw. Don't look so ugly. Is that cool? Change to channel spirit. Mandresti ivravakoto. Zumara veresiti le mambra dosa dura baha. Hoo robrava roseke. You've got to switch to channel spirit. Let's all stand. Everybody out loud say, Eternal Father, today by choice, I'm going to switch to channel spirit. I want to walk in the spirit. I want to live by the spirit. I'm going to talk in the spirit. I'm going to stay in the spirit. I'm not depressed. I'm not suppressed. I'm not oppressed. I'm lifted high. I'm a star. I'm flying high. I'm not coming down low. I'm living by the spirit. I've got Holy Spirit languages to help me be edified and pray mysteries to God. I will not neglect it, but I will go for more. I receive today brand new infillings of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, I'm going to break through today. Right, let's all just stand, come together right by the front. We're going to pray together in unison in Malamombroshichichilebrevenaha. Okay, so we're going to close our eyes and we're going to just for 1 minute, just in the Holy Ghost, go. Moto shelebar. Right, now go for it, please. Stay there. Don't get out of it. Walk in it. Live in it. I release a free flow of the Holy Ghost. Take all baffles and stops out. Take all silences out. Get you a free flow. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Whoa, the mama, the city, the banana, the whole.